Good morning, students. In the last class, we studied about seed. So recall in short, seed. Seed is fertilized ovule. Ovule is with integuments, the coverings. Coverings, the integuments forms the seed coat. So a seed is with outermost seed coat, internally with the cotyledon or cotyledons and embryonic axis. The micropyle of the ovule forms a opening on the surface of the seed coat, which facilitates movement of oxygen as well as water for the seed to germinate. We studied types of seeds, endospermic and non-endospermic. Under that, we studied one concept known as perisperm, seen in beet as well as black pepper. It is nothing but a residual or persistent remnant of nucellus over the seed. It is called perisperm. Continuation of that. Dormancy, a concept known as dormancy. As seeds mature, their moisture content gets reduced. Seeds mature, their moisture content gets reduced. Usually 10 to 12 to 15% when moisture is reduced, a seed with very less moisture content means in its the metabolic activity is reduced. Such a seed is called dormant seed, or seed is in a condition known as dormancy. So when the moisture content in the seed is reduced to 12 to 15%, seeds are said to be dry, metabolically less active. The seed is called dormant seeds and the process is called dormancy. To a dormant seed, what is dormant? It is in a period of rest. To a dormant seed, when suitable temperature, adequate moisture and oxygen are given, it germinates. So dormancy is nothing but a state of rest during which seed is alive. When the conditions which are suitable for the germination are given, even a dormant seed germinates. Then continuation. Advantages of seeds to angiosperms. What are the advantages of seeds to angiosperms? First one, reproductive process, sexual reproduction. End product of sexual reproduction is seed. Reproductive process includes two steps, pollination and fertilization. Both the process in angiosperms does not require water, are independent of water. The two processes, pollination and fertilization, which occur in the sexual reproductive process, are independent of water. What about seed formation? Seed formation is dependable. There is a sentence in your textbook like this. Seed formation is dependable. Means what? Seed formation is dependable on pollination and fertilization. Seed formation is dependent upon pollination and fertilization. Yes, seed reproductive process depends upon all these two, which are independent of water. In the case of angiosperms, water is not required. Why? Male gametes are carried close to the female gamete by pollen tube, siphonogamy we say. Siphono refers to tube. Pollen tube carries the male gamete to the close to the female gamete. So water is not required. The process are independent of water and seed formation is dependable. Seed formation depends upon pollination and fertilization. Better adaptive strategies to get dispersed to new areas and get colonized, settle in the new areas. Different seeds have different adaptive strategies which helps for their dispersal and to settle in the other dispersed areas. That is another property of seed. Seeds have better adaptive strategies which helps for their dispersal to the new area and also help them to colonize, that is to settle in the new area. Sufficient reserve food in them. The cotyledons contain sufficient reserve food in them. These reserve food, which is present in the cotyledon, supplies nutrition for the initial developing seedling until the seedling becomes seedling can prepare its own food by photosynthesis. Yes, seeds have sufficient reserve food which helps, which supplies energy or food to the young growing seedling until the seedling can produce its own food by the process of photosynthesis. Seeds have a hard seed coat. Seeds have a hard seed coat which protects the seed, which protects the inner embryo. The hard seed coat of the seed protects the inner embryo. Seeds. Seeds are the product of sexual reproduction. So they bring genetic combination which are responsible for variations. Yes, seeds are the products of sexual reproduction. They bring genetic combinations which are responsible for variations. Seeds of most of the plants are taken as food by animals. Food for animals. Seeds are the basis of agriculture. So these are the advantages of seeds to angiosperms. That is, seed production is dependable on pollination as well as fertilization. Seeds have some adaptive strategies to disperse to new areas and get colonized in that area. Seeds have sufficient reserve food which helps for the initial seedling growth. Seeds are having a seed coat which protects the young embryo inside it. Seeds are the products of sexual reproduction which brings genetic combinations which are responsible for bringing variations. Most of the seeds are used as food by animals. Seeds are the basis of agriculture. Thank you. viability of seeds. We studied the same thing in the case of pollen grains. So what is viability? Viability is how many days they survive, lifetime of a seed. Viability of the seeds. In few, seeds are viable for few months, whereas in others for few years. Viability period varies from species to species. Few records of viability are two. One is Lupinus arcticus. Lupinus arcticus excavated from Arctic tundra. That's why arcticus, Arctic tundra. The seeds of Lupinus arcticus excavated from Arctic tundra germinated and flowered after 10,000 years of dormancy. After 10,000 years of dormancy, that is one of the oldest seed which germinated after years of 10,000 years of dormancy. One more is Phoenix dactylifera. Phoenix dactylifera is date palm. Is date palm. Phoenix dactylifera is a date palm. Its seeds were found during the archaeological excavation near King Herod's palace near Dead Sea. The seeds germinated and flowered by a dormancy period or after 2000 years of dormancy. 2000 years. So these are the two records for viability of seeds. So viability varies. Two records are Lupinus arcticus and Phoenix dactylifera. The Lupinus arcticus seeds germinated after a dormancy of 10,000 years. These germinated after a dormancy of 2,000 years. Dicot seed. How is a dicot seed? A typical dicot seed. Think of a bean seed. Bean seed. So this is a bean seed. Somewhat kidney shaped they are with the seed coat. This is the outermost seed coat. The outer coat is tough, protective. So think of, we remove the outer coat. This is one more coat, the thin coat. So outer coat, after removal, thin coat. After that we can see two cotyledons. We can separate the two cotyledons like this. Here the two cotyledons are separated. So a dicot seed is with the two cotyledons. A dicot seed is with the two cotyledons. And this the inner coat, this is the outer coat. Outer is dark, protective, hard. Inner coat is thin. After the removal of inner coat also, we can see internally two cotyledons and somewhere the embryo is also seen. So on one side, this seed when viewed, we can see the micropyle. That is, the micropyle is that of the ovule. This micropyle is now changed into a small pore, a opening through which oxygen and water enters into the seed. So that is a typical dicot seed. Now a typical monocot seed. Typical monocot seed, you studied already in first year, seed maize. Maize, recall the maize grain, maize grain, maize grain. Speciality of maize grain is that what is seed, outermost covering of the seed, seed coat. At the same time, outermost covering of the fruit is pericarp. In this case, this is the seed coat, at the same time this is the fruit wall. That is, in this case, the outermost fruit wall, that is the pericarp, is fused with the seed coat. So this is, we can say, the seed coat, or this is, we can say, the pericarp. So what is pericarp? Pericarp is nothing but the fruit wall, outermost fruit wall. So what is this maize? Maize is endospermic seed. So this major portion is endosperm. Major portion is endosperm. So what is monocot seed with a single cotyledon? The single cotyledon is called scutellum. The single cotyledon is called scutellum. So this is plumule and this is radical. Plumule. This is plumule and this is the radical. Radical is protected by coleorrhiza and plumule is protected by coleoptile. So this is coleoptile and this is coleorrhiza. Coleorrhiza. So that is a typical monocot seed. A typical monocot seed. So typical monocot seed is maize. Can be explained like this. This is longitudinal section of maize grain. Is with the pericarp or seed coat, endosperm, major portion of the endosperm, on one side one single cotyledon, the scutellum, with the embryonic axis, radical and plumule, protected by coleorrhiza and coleoptile. So under post-fertilization structure and events, we studied endosperm, embryo, seed, remaining is fruit. So seed we studied, fertilized ovule. So what is fruit? Fertilized ovary. Fertilized ovary is fruit. Fruit. Fruit is with its own wall. Wall of the fruit is called pericarp. Wall of the fruit is called pericarp. In some fruits, it is differentiated into different layers. Epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp are the different names or the layers. Endocarp. So fruit wall is called pericarp, which is differentiated into epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp. Fruits are of different types. Few fruits we say fleshy fruits. Few fruits we say dry fruits. Few are true fruits. Few are false fruits or pseudo fruits. Few are parthenocarpic fruits. So fruits are of different types: true, false or pseudo, fleshy and dry. What they are? So what is fruit actually? Fruit is fertilized ovary. Ovary changes into fruit after the process of pollination and fertilization. Recall ovary. Ovary style stigma. This ovary, entire ovary, now changes into fruit. So what is fruit? Fertilized ovary. Now imagine few fruits. Guava, mango, sapota, banana. All these are fleshy at maturity. All these are fleshy at maturity, are fleshy fruits. That is, at maturity, their fruit wall, pericarp, is fleshy. That's why the name fleshy fruits. Guava, mango, orange are few example. At maturity, the pericarp is dry, are dry fruits. Mustard, groundnut are few example. At maturity, their pericarp is dry. True fruits. What is fruit? Fruit is fertilized ovary. When fruits are produced from ovary, then it is a true fruit. When fruits are produced from part of the flower other than ovary, think of flower. Flower is having a stalk, pedicel. Above the stalk, I told thalamus, calyx, corolla, androecium, like that. So if fruit is produced from part of the flower other than ovary, then they are false fruit. So what is true fruit? Fruits which are produced from ovary are true fruits. Ovary are true fruits. Mango, guava are true fruits, whereas false fruit or pseudo fruit are one which are produced from part of the flower other than ovary. For false fruit, one example is apple. Apple is a false fruit. Strawberry, false fruit. The juicy fruit, what we see in cashew nut, we say cashew. juicy fruit, that is false fruit. Then what is false fruit? False fruit is one which is produced from part of the flower other than ovary. Think of apple. So in this apple, this portion is the one which we eat, edible portion we say. What is this central portion? Is the portion what actually we throw out. So this portion, the edible portion, which is produced from the thalamus of flower. So that's why this is not the one which is produced from the ovary. This is one which is produced from the thalamus. That's why it comes under pseudo fruit category. The true fruit is inside. This is true fruit, which we can see inside the fruit is with the seeds. So this is a true fruit and the edible portion is false. Similarly, in the case of strawberry also, same thing in the case of cashew nut. The juicy fruit what we eat is actually the swollen part of the pedicel, stalk of the flower, and down we can see a kidney shaped structure, that is actually the true fruit which internally contain seeds. The juicy fruit does not contain any seeds. Fruits are produced as a result of sexual reproduction. Think of a case, if fruits are produced without sexual reproduction, without pollination and fertilization, then such fruits are called parthenocarpic fruit. Parthenocarpic fruits are the one which are produced without pollination, fertilization, without fertilization. Parthenocarpic fruit, another category. So in nature, there are some fruits which are naturally parthenocarpic. Naturally parthenocarpic. One example is banana. So what is parthenocarpic fruit? Fruit which are produced without fertilization. Fruits which are produced without fertilization are parthenocarpic fruit. Naturally parthenocarpic fruit is banana. Parthenocarpy can be induced. Now think of grapes. In market we get grapes with the seeds, at the same time grapes without seeds. We say seedless fruits. So seedless grapes have more commercial value. That's why plant breeders try to produce seedless fruits by a technology known as parthenocarpy. That is, parthenocarpy can be induced. Parthenocarpy can be induced. So what is that? Flowers, just before they open, they are treated with the growth hormones. So before fertilization only, the ovary changes into fruit. As a result, such fruits are seedless. So parthenocarpy occurs in nature also in few. Parthenocarpy can also be induced. Which contain many seeds. Recall few fruits. Mango, we see only one seed inside the fruit. There are some fruits which contain thousands of seeds. One example are orchids. Two more examples are parasitic forms like Orobanchi and Striga. These contain thousands of seeds. That is about fruit. So what is fruit? Types of fruit. How parthenocarpy can be induced? What are the different types of fruits? Few fruits contain many seeds. Example are orchids, parasitic forms like Orobanchi and Striga are few examples. two more concept. One is apomixis. Apomixis. Apo refers to away. Apo refers to away. Away from mixing is the word meaning. Apomixis. Before that, what are seeds? Seeds are the product of sexual reproduction. Seeds are the products of sexual reproduction. Seeds are produced as a result of fertilization. But there are few families in Asteraceae, in grasses, seeds are produced without fertilization. Seeds are produced without fertilization. That is, seeds are produced by a process of asexual reproduction. Seeds are produced by a process of asexual reproduction. That is, it is a asexual reproduction, but it mimics, copies sexual reproduction. Why? Seeds are produced. That's why it copies sexual reproduction. So it is a asexual reproduction which mimics sexual reproduction. Why? Since seeds are produced. Think of an egg cell. What is egg cell? Female gamete. Usually egg cells are haploid. Think of 2N egg cell. What is 2N egg cell? When reduction division fails to occur during the formation of egg, egg cells are 2N. When think of a 2N egg cell. Egg cell is 2N. When failure in the reduction division occurs, no meiosis. Meiosis fails during the formation of egg cell. Such a egg cell is 2N. That 2N egg cell directly changes into embryo. Where this occurs? This occurs inside the ovule. That ovule now changes into seed. Now that seed is one with this, which is with the embryo. The embryo is a 2N, but this is produced from 2N egg cell. No fusion of male gametes, like that. No fusion of male gametes. Such a special case is apomixis. So away from mixing, this 2N, this egg cell won't get mixed with the male gamete. Away from mixing is apomixis. 2N egg cell, 2N, yes, 2N, because of the failure in the reduction division during the formation of an egg. 2N egg cell directly changes into embryo. So this embryo is produced without fertilization. The concept is called apomixis, away from mixing. Seen in two families, grasses and in Asteraceae. Grasses as well as Asteraceae. So what is apomixis? Apomixis is away from mixing. Seeds are produced as a result of fertilization, but in the family Asteraceae and grasses, seeds are produced without sexual reproduction. Seeds are not produced because of fertilization. Seeds are produced because of asexual reproduction. So this is a type of asexual reproduction which mimics, copies a sexual reproduction. One example is diploid egg cell. Diploid, 2N egg cell directly changes into embryo without fertilization is apomixis. Continuation. What are the advantages of apomixis? The seeds which are produced as a result of apomixis are called apomictic seeds. Apomictic seeds. What are the advantages of this? Before that, recall another concept. We study the word hybrid. Hybrid seeds, we say. Hybrid seeds. Usually hybrid seeds are produced in food crops as well as vegetables. Hybrid seeds are produced in food crops as well as in vegetables, since they give more yield, higher yield. Yes, hybrids are produced in food crops as well as vegetables. If the seeds from the hybrids are collected and sown, they show segregation of characters in the progeny. Plants in the further progeny show segregation of characters. Means the hybrid vigor from generation to generation become less, decreases. The hybrid vigor decreases. So hybrid seeds, when sown, from generation to generation, the hybrid vigor goes on decreasing. That's why usually hybrid seeds are produced for every year. So hybrid seed production is costly. That's why the cost of hybrid seeds is also more. Hybrid seed production is costly. That's why cost of hybrid seeds is also more. Now think of, instead of that, if hybrid seeds are made from the process of apomixis. Hybrid seeds are made by the process of apomixis. Segregation of characters won't occur. Why? The same character retains. Only one female, egg cell changes into the same character can be retained. So no segregation of characters, So usually hybrid seeds nowadays are made apomictic, so that the hybrid vigor, as well as no segregation of characters. Think of a farmer. In this case, first case, he has to purchase hybrid seeds every year. But in this case, he can keep the seeds for sowing for the next generations. No need to purchase the seeds every year, which is helpful for the farmer. So that is an advantage for apomictic seeds. So because of apomixis, the seed produced are called apomictic seeds. Are the one which are produced like this. It is a type of asexual reproduction which mimics a sexual reproduction. Okay, that is apomixis. Another concept is polyembryony. Polyembryony. We studied ovule changes into seed, zygote changes into embryo. Usually like that. Now this is a concept in which, imagine, this is the embryo sac. Embryo sac is inside the nucellus. Nucellus cells are diploid. In these two members, in few varieties of citrus and mango, this nucellus cell protrude into the embryo sac. What are nucellus cells? 2N. They protrude into the embryo sac and results in the formation of embryos. 2N. That's why embryos are 2N. Yes, the nucellus cells, 2N, protrude from here, they move. From here, they move into the embryo sac and changes into embryo. Think of, when this ovule changes into seed, that seed is with many embryos, depending upon how many nucellus cells are moved inside, like that. So this seed, this ovule, when it changes into seed, this seed is with many embryos. That condition is called polyembryony. Presence of more than one embryo inside the seed. presence of more than one embryo inside the seed is polyembryony, seen in some varieties of mango and citrus. Polyembryony. So what is polyembryony? Presence of more than one embryo inside the seed. How it is? Seed is produced from ovule. Recall ovule? Nucellus, internally the embryo sac. Diploid cells of the nucellus move inside into the embryo sac and they produce embryo. As a result, when that ovule changes into seed, that seed is with many embryos. Thank you.